Hi friends, this is Sue Betty from the Bluebird Tavern in Burlington, Vermont. Tend, Exploring the Vermont Foodscape, is a series of video postcards from the many farmers, cheesemakers, brewers, bakers, and other businesses that supply our restaurant with incredible local ingredients. This is a story about how dozens of creative and hardworking people are making a living by producing truly excellent regional products. Hey friends, this is Sue from Bluebird Tavern, and I'm at the Cellars at Jasper Hill with Mateo, who's the cheesemaker here, winner of many awards.
One or two.
Yeah, do you want to just talk a little bit about what you do here?
Sure. Well, the Cellars at Jasper Hill is phase two of our business. Here we milk 40 cows. We make four or five different cheeses, and we started the Cellars as a means of lowering the barriers to entry for cheesemakers in Vermont and dairy farmers specifically looking to transition into value-added production and as a means of keeping their farms viable. And the Cellars is a piece of infrastructure we're leveraging to keep our working landscape working. So that's what we're doing here.
Very cool.
Want to go see some cheese?
I'd love to.
All right. Wash our hands up.
Wow. Cheese age anywhere from 10 to 14 months. So we're kind of right in this like 12, 13 month range, which is my favorite month. So every wheel, or every batch, I'm sorry, has a test wheel in it. So you can go through and taste, and it allows us both to test for quality, testing pH and moisture during the aging process, but also tasting it, especially as it gets to that kind of 9 month range when it's almost ready for sale. This is how we determine one batch from another. And there's a surprising amount of batch variation. It's coming from a single herd milk source. So there's gonna be a huge difference from batch to batch in flavor, and texture, and aroma. Always delicious though. So, put the plug in. This is a specially designed cheddar plug for cheeses that are a little bit longer aged. And then you get the pleasure of taking a piece. Can you take a piece and still hold the camera?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, so.
Take the same piece there?
Yep, you got it. Do you want to taste? So this is the April 7th batch.
Oh, man.
Which, to me, has lots of like a preserved lemon, like tangy quality, but also has this like savory, like beef broth quality as well. So it's a neat component of like tangy and sweet and savory. 10 years ago, this wasn't even an idea yet. Maybe it was in Mateo's brain somewhere, but 10 years ago, this was just a hill. This was rock. So, and cheese in particular, in the last 10 years, has been pretty astounding to see where it's come from. It's always been there. There's always been kind of a cottage industry in the U.S. for cheesemaking. But now, I think American artisan scale cheesemakers are making stuff that's comparable or better than a lot of the cheeses that are getting imported from Europe. And it's pretty neat to be a part of that and to see that grow. And obviously we're, in some respect, kind of standing on the shoulders of giants, like, you know, learning as much as we can from the European cheesemaking tradition. But it's very unique in that we're kind of starting this own separate, segregated path that we're learning from each other instead of just learning from the French experts, right? So, and Vermont is the place to be for cheesemaking these days. It's over 40 cheesemakers, highest per capita number of cheesemakers than any other state in the country. So, it's fun to be a part of it.
This really started with a completely emotional, irrational, compulsive decision to buy a piece of land here in Greensboro. It was the last chunk of land that was going to be up for sale for a generation as far as we could tell. And we bought this farm. We had no idea what we were going to do with it. And we had one basic, you know, goal, and that really was to engage in meaningful work in a place that we love. So we had the place that we loved part figured out, and then the meaningful work kind of flowed out of that. And for us, this is really about building an economic future on a landscape that that's dear to our hearts. So we're hoping that what we can accomplish over the course of a lifetime is, you know, a vitality and a maintenance of the working landscape up here in the Northeast Kingdom of Vermont. And the rest of it is just been, you know, an ad hoc set of decisions and capitalizing on opportunities as they came along. Cabot Clothbound is an important part of our business because, as you can see, this is a cheese that is, you know, it's beautiful to look at, but it's got an amazing flavor, and it provides the sellers with the weight, which we're using to build a distribution system for other cheesemakers in the region, as well as the cash flow to maintain our organization and this piece of infrastructure. We have some overhead now.
Right.
So Cabot Clothbound is like a core product for us. And I like to describe it as cheese with a purpose.
Right.
Because, you know, when you're like, when you buy a piece of Cabot Clothbound, you're actually making a whole lot of other things possible. We are actually leveraging this one product to the benefit of the rest of the producers and the sellers. It's an interesting model. We are all connected here. And, you know, that's the great thing about a local food scene, you know, that we're privileged to be a part of. Both Bluebird and the Cellars and Pete's and, you know, the rest of the producers that, you know, get a real feature on your menu is that we're all connected, and Bluebird is a place really where a lot of us come together, and it's tidy that way.